Okay guys, after you print the parts from Rc-Jetprint and you pre-glued these parts like the canopy, the wings, tail sections, you need also to have a carbon rods. So you need two tubes, carbon rods, all 10 millimeters. So this one is 1 meter, this one is 80 centimeters and this one is 60 centimeters. And I will go later in this video specifically how this landing gear works, which we also designed to print. So you don't need to buy any retracts. This is already looking really amazing. So let's start working on the fuselage. What is really nice with Bamboo Lab, I can add the complete project into the Bamboo Lab project file, where you can easily upload your prints to the Bamboo Lab. So in this case, I'm using a Bamboo Lab, but in this particular build, weight is not that super critical as the F35B. So to head up a little bit about this project, this project is based on the F35B from Rc-Jetprint. We received many questions about FPV cameras and your own flight setup. So this will be a nice platform to test your own parts and electronics on it. But yeah, let's start building it. Each and every folder came with a picture set, so you can easily see the way how you need to build the airplane. And in this case, I start with the front lifting fan module, which is really stable, and we're going to proceed working to the back. Okay, well, the Bamboo Lab is printing the last two parts for the fuselage. I already added the wheels, so this is a nice opportunity to adjust the wheels with the front suspension. And it's starting already to look like a tricycle. Cool. Also here, make sure you keep 20 millimeters left where you can add the front canopy. So the front steering servo is installed, which works really nice, and I really love the suspension. Great job, Rc-Jetprint. So let's continue the build. I'm still waiting for these two parts. They're running on the Bamboo Lab, so I can start adding the wing tubes. Just a tip, before you install the wing tubes, you need the mid section first, like so. And then you will stick the tube in to work on the rest. So it starts already to look like the Kestrel model, a full VTOL trainer. So the first wing sections are added. So on both sides, you will have 270 millimeters left to stick out to fit the main wings. Oh boy, it starts really, really to look awesome, more and more. So let's see if the parts are ready from the Bamboo Lab, and then we can continue with the tail section. Wow, such a crazy speed with this Bamboo Lab. And luckily, I've got two. Thank you, Bamboo Lab, for supporting this project. Well, saying that, I think this is also a nice way to get the ad of PCBWay. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay provides custom PCB services, but they also offer 3D printing, CNC machining, sheet fabrication, and many more. We use CNC and also 3D printing to make our projects. Mostly I use PCBWay to CNC cut aluminium parts for the F-35 landing gear. At PCBWay you can easily upload your file, select the material that you want, and get a quote in less than 24 hours. Check them out at PCBWay.com. And let's go back to our video. Wow, look at this guys, it's starting to to get really, really awesome. Wow, so we're still waiting at the Bamboo Lab. This is almost finished, it's still 20 minutes to go when it's finished. So this is a nice opportunity to assemble the thrust vector unit and the ducting unit. And hopefully we can also fly it today. But let's proceed. Okay, let us start with the wing. I'm going to install a 40 millimeter EDF, which is a 4S 5000 kV EDF, which is really, really nice. And I'm going to install the high techs. I'm using the HS70MG, which is a nice digital servo. So the wing is prepared. So we have also made a small bracket where you can install the servo, and then we will glue it inside of this piece. It's quite straight on, super easy. Okay guys, we're coming to a point that all actuators, motors are installed. I hope you like the build so far. It's a really easy and very cheap build to do. Only those EDFs, yeah, maybe I'm using anyway the 70s from JP Hobby. These are brilliant. They are super, super lightweight, and they can push almost 3 kilos, these small 70 millimeters. So I recommend these because you got lots of power to climb for vertical takeoff. So what we're going to do now is to install the KK2 board. All the settings, you can find them on rcjetprints.com. And you can simply download the configuration for the KK2. There will be a small manual how to wire up all those servos and ESCs. And yeah, again, this is it flies easy like an Cessna. So let's proceed building then. And here we have a completed Kestrel. So for the next video, and for the guys who got questions, I will make a detailed video about the KK2 board. You will find a lot of information on RC groups under section VTOLs, and it's called Open Aero VTOL. But the setup is quite easy. We got a VTOL mixer, we got ailerons, and we got a simple drone setup as a T section. And we got one simple servo who controls the ducting area. So let's give her a first spin. Okay guys, we're going to perform a vertical takeoff. We're going into transition, do a course, and we go back to vertical landing. And when this is successful, the files will be online tonight. We got the drone filming from the air for the guys who wants to see the complete footage. But this is going to be awesome. Okay, let's prepare and wait for this pilot to land, and then we can go. We got some nice weather condition.
Even wachten. Ja, hij loopt.
Had je misschien nog iets meer snelheid op kunnen bouwen? Nice.
Het is wel mooi helemaal weer, hè? Ja.
Succes, dacht ik zo. Nice.
Dat was hem. Kom beter.
Ja.
Ging goed hoor.
Ging een stuk beter als net.
Mooi.
We gaan dadelijk een bochtje maken naar de verticale landing.
Ja. Ik zou gewoon van die kant afkomen, Joël. Gewoon van die kant.